today I am going to be speaking to you about. How to overcome rejection. So, you have come to see me, yes.
Okay.
And you need help with overcoming rejection.
Very good.
You are in the right place. That is no problem. Why is it that you are feeling rejection? For why is it that you are feeling rejection? Why is that? Why are you afraid to step out and accomplish your dreams because of being afraid that you will be rejected? Why is it that you are afraid to love someone and let them in your heart? Because you are afraid that you are going to be rejected. Is it that you are afraid to step out boldly and accomplish your goals, be it music, be it college, be it acting, any kind of career, because you are afraid of being rejected? Yes, okay. I am going to let you know something that will fix the problem. You are very beautiful here. First of all, we need to look at the fear. Why do you have fear? Let us remove your fear. There is nothing to fear. If someone rejects you, you're not going to die. creation cannot die, nor can it be destroyed. So there is absolutely nothing for you to fear. So let us remove your fear of everything. The next thing that you need to remember is that you are enough. One of the biggest evils in this world is that we have people believing that they're not good enough or that they're never enough. That's why you're afraid of rejection, because you do not feel as if you are enough. You do not feel as if you are good enough. Somewhere, sometime in your life, somebody convinced you that you are not good enough, that you will not amount to much. Maybe they convince you that you're not smart enough or not pretty enough. But your looks is not good enough. This is what can be done on the media as well, the way the models portray themselves in beautiful skinny bodies and perfect flawless makeup, and the world believes that that is the true image of beauty, but it really is not. So, countless thousands and thousands all over the world believe that that is the image they have to keep in order to be accepted and good enough. This is why social media can be destructive. Comparing yourself to others, whether it's being around you or on social media, but you need to know that you are good enough. You are enough. If you look at some of the famous superstars that we all try to be like Marilyn Monroe, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, all these people that you can find who were so beautiful on stage and on the TV. Deep inside their hearts, they were dying. But deep inside their hearts were broken, because they never felt as if they were enough. Now Marilyn Monroe, her mother rejected her as a child, and this is where she never felt good enough. Is that what happened to you? Someone rejected you as a child? Father, an aunt, a teacher. But there is the truth. So, my love, we are not going to stop until you have convinced yourself that you are enough. Until you have convinced yourself that you are complete and whole and lacking nothing. Until you have convinced yourself that there is nothing, absolutely nothing wrong with you. That you are perfect just the way you are. But even more importantly, that you are enough. You should repeat these words after me. Go ahead. I am enough. Let's make it a part of your subconscious mind. Say it again. I am enough. I am enough. obstacles and trials and hardships. It's contrast. And we need contrast in our lives sometimes. Or we need contrast in our lives all the times, because contrast keeps us on our toes. Contrast tells us where we are vibrationally. What we are putting out into the universe comes back to us through contrast. So sometimes when you are seeing these things, trials and hardships and negativity showing up in your life, it is the universe's way of showing you what is in your vibration, because we can only attract into our lives what is in our vibration. So contrast is necessary. Contrast is necessary. Contrast is necessary, like just like a grain of sand in an oyster. Yes. Contrast is necessary in your life, just like coal placed in fire to be refined. Contrast is necessary. Contrast is sandpaper to your soul. Contrast is necessary in your life, just like gold under pressure that turns to diamonds. So you see, we should not despise contrast, not despise hardships in our life, because sometimes the greatest gems have to take the greatest amount of pressure. That's because contrast and hardships and trials and rejection is showing up in your life. Don't think it means that something is wrong with you. No. Great contrast can only be attracted to great people. Okay? The hardships in your life will determine and show to you what level of greatness you have in store in your destiny. So do not despise the hard things in your life. Do not despise pain and suffering. Don't despise it. It doesn't feel pleasant, no, but it is telling you something, and you will overcome it. Let's start with rejection, because rejection is rooted in the fact that you feel that you're not good enough, and that is false, because that is false. You are good enough, not because someone in authority made a statement about you means that statement is true. You are good enough. You are more than enough. Most of the emotional disorders that you find right now is rooted in the fact that we tend to believe that we are not good enough. Then our minds take it all from there, and we begin to think and imagine all kinds of untrue things about ourselves, because we believe that we are not good enough. Well, you are more than good enough. You are enough. If there is someone in your life that you love, but you are afraid to let this person in, or you're afraid to find love, or you're afraid to stand up for yourself because you are in a relationship that might not be good for you, because you don't feel good enough, it is time for you to break free from that. It is time for you to realize that you are more than good enough. You are enough. catastrofe.